Without entering into the whys and wherefores, the pros and cons of the trouble in Lebanon, we offer these pictures of recent incidents in Beirut, the capital. When the French authorities in Lebanon arrested President Belkari El-Khoury and his cabinet ministers, the people revolted and demonstrations were the order of the day. The British and American governments were disturbed at the turn of affairs, and the situation became hourly more acute. The atmosphere became calmer as the attitude of the British became known, and much relief was felt all round when the British Minister of State, resident in the Middle East, Mr. R.G. Casey, arrived in Beirut for consultations with Sir Edward Spears, the British Minister in Lebanon. Only a few hours before these pictures of Sir Edward Spears were taken, French troops had clashed with a Lebanon crowd, and there were some casualties. A most regrettable affair described by General Katrou as a painful misunderstanding. Anyway, the President and his ministers are now released and back in office, and the latest word we have is that normal life has been resumed.
The new Cheka Bypass, a fine roadway built through the Syrian hills by Royal Engineers of the 9th Army in the record time of 100 days. Men of many nationalities were employed in its construction, and now the day of its official opening is at hand. The ceremony is performed by the President of the Lebanese Republic, Mr. Bakar Kari, whose sudden arrest shortly afterwards by the French Committee of National Liberation caused a menacing situation. With General Holmes, GOC 9th Army, the now reinstated president carries out an inspection of the Guard of Honor. The unveiling of a monument is part of the ceremony marking the conclusion of an engineering achievement of considerable importance. The road is now open, but political avenues with France were to be found a great deal harder to travel.